Hi everybody, I'm going to talk about major assignments 3A. I'm going to start at the expense in the population project, which is the second tab. Under this tab, there are four sections: transportation, logic, food and supply, or miscellaneous. Under transportation, I have listed airplane tickets and rental car. I assume the mission is going to be in Ethiopia, and there are five team members, and they will go to Ethiopia. Also they may rent a van. After 5 years, right? That's the mission is after 5 years, but as of today, one airplane ticket costs $1,300, and also the second item, a rental car, one van is gonna be rented, 20 Ethiopian birr, and we're gonna convert that to dollar. I'm gonna show you how. Right, converting Ethiopian birr to dollar. Conversion rate is $1 is equivalent to 30 Ethiopian birr. So converting to 20,000 birr to $2, we may use this formula: given foreign currency times conversion rate. So in this case, 20 Ethiopian birr times the rate, which is $1 per 30 bucks. So you cancel birr against birr. So you're left with 20,000 times 1 divided by 30 is going to be $667 when you round it. All right, let's go back to the Excel. So as of now, or as of today, the airplane tickets for 5 people is going to be $1,300, and rental car for 2 weeks is going to be 666, about that much costs. Right, this is a dollar amount. Now we're gonna project how much it would be after 5 years. So to do so, I'm gonna show you how to do it. We're gonna use a CPI data link. We're gonna click here, and then we're gonna have this information. I already copy and paste from 2009 all the way to 2009. And the CPI is right here, as you see it here, all the way to 2019. And instead of the year, I use time from 0 to 10. So 2009 is going to be 0, 2019 is going to be 10. So we're going to find out how much would be the CPI in 2024, which is a 15. To find this out, the CPI, I'm going to show you how to find out. So I'm going to highlight those two data first and go to Insert. Click here, Chart. Click Scatter. Now, depending on your Excel version, it may have different application, but mine, I have to go click Quick Layout and go to the 9 layout part. I click right here and I have this information, the equation for this regression line. I'm gonna go to home and make it a little bit bigger. All right, let me move the equation to the right side. All right, now my equation for the regression line is y equals 3.8944x plus 216.9. So x is the year, and in time it is a 15 one, as you see here. Let me show you. the x is 15 here, or 10, 9.